मैम आप एक बार अपनी ऑडियंस के लिए फ्लेक्स कर दीजिए। यू गॉट दैट?
हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द पीजी लॉग्स। मैं हूं आपकी होस्ट और दोस्त पलोमी। इट इज एक्सट्रीमली अनफॉर्चुनेट कैसे औरतों को हमेशा नाजुक समझा जाता है एंड नॉट फियरलेस एंड ऑडिशियस। इवन इफ वी टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ अ स्पोर्ट बॉडी बिल्डिंग that is largely considered a man's sport. We're exposing your body to show musculature and symmetry. That is not considered the kind of women's work. Khair meri to hai. To break such taboos, there was a woman who followed her dreams despite the barriers that came her. One of the pioneering female bodybuilders in India, she won her pro card from the International Federation of Bodybuilding. She's not just a bodybuilder, but also a Bharatnatyam dancer, a prolific writer, and the World Peace Ambassador. ऐसे कई सारे national और international awards जीतकर उन्होंने हमारे देश को सम्मान दिया। Ladies and gentlemen, I have with me Rita Jera.
Ma'am, bodybuilding is a sport that is considered largely for the men. We're exposing body to show muscularity and symmetry. That is not considered the kind of women's work. And even so, the things are changing. It is changing at a very slow pace. But the stigma against female bodybuilding is still fresh. What inspired you to set out your foot in this industry?
Okay, you know, there has been a paradigm change regarding what bodybuilding is all about. Women have come in, even after the International Olympic Committee was formed, you know, women were not participating in any of the sports initially. It was much later that women started participating in sports. Now, you know, as the society is changing and people are evolving, there are women divisions. In fact, now no sport is taken into Olympics unless and until there is a woman division of in it. Yeah. That is after 1991.
Yeah.
When bodybuilding started, it was of course only men. Even now, it is a male-dominating sport. But the International Federation of Bodybuilding has realized that whatever few women were there already in it, most of the women would not relate to that kind of a body, and it wasn't an all-inclusive sport when it really comes to celebrating womanhood in the real sense. So they have come out with divisions like women's physique, figure, bikini, and the women's fitness. And also now next year we will be having women's wellness in the International Federation, in the Pro League.
Yeah.
So that is the purpose, is that every woman is different and she has, you know, right from a different skeletal structure to a different genetic disposition. So if a woman wants to reach her genetic potential, all she has to do is train well and work on her strengths and sculpt her body into a piece of art. And that's a beautiful thing to do, because that bodybuilding, if you look at it otherwise, in a real sense, is a very positive sport. It is an all-encompassing field. So we want to be the best version of ourselves. And I feel that today, every person who is, you know, measuring their diet, who is training hard, working hard, and getting himself to the best of his abilities, is actually a bodybuilder. So it doesn't have to be competitive bodybuilding. How I started was, and why I got into competition was that my son, he wanted to, when he was in 10th standard and was just the middle of puberty years, he wanted to be like one of the Bollywood stars. And so I took him along with the gym, and he needed my help because he has certain challenges with the autism. So I had to be with him. And then at that time, a lot of trainers kept telling me that you shouldn't be doing weight training, you're a woman. Whereas for women, it's all the more essential, because the bones should get that kind of resistance. And you know, after menopause, so many women suffer with osteoporosis. I wanted to really fight that out. And I started, you know, getting better at it. And you know, I started taking part in small competitions. I got myself certified so that I could talk about it. And in the process, eventually, because I was probably the only one at that time, I went on to competing, and then that's how I started my competing career.
Ma'am, as we read, you had a very difficult childhood, right? Even you talked about challenges with your son. And you also spent hours at your neighbors, right? Even after marriage, things probably did not go your way. But even after all these challenges, you managed to build yourself as the person who you are today, and not just in the field of bodybuilding, also in the field of dance and music. How did you manage to do all this?
Okay, you know, they say that when God closes one door, then other doors are opened. I kind of, because my mother, she was a patient of schizophrenia. Yeah. And so she had to, she would lose control over herself. She used to get auditory hallucinations and she used to respond to that. So I had a very, very difficult childhood. And so we lived a lot of life in isolation. And I, you know, kind of craved for love. And the only way, you know, being in isolation, I could think of anybody giving me all the adulation as a child was to enhance myself. So at a very early age, I always strive to be very good at my studies. I used my solitude to practice, whether it's music or whether it's my own studies and education. So when I was very little, I used to, you know, even when I was a very small child, I started doing, because in those days this was very, you know, ubiquitous. I used to do a lot of embroidery, knit sweaters. I did everything in the world so that I could learn and enrich myself. And then obviously I grew up to be that kind of person. So when my son had to learn skating, you know, he was told to do balancing exercises. I did it with him. When I taught him swimming, I competed with him. So, and that's how when I went to the gym, I started bodybuilding. Now, essentially, I was more into academics and I loved my studies. Of course, after marriage, my in-laws wouldn't want me to focus so much on studies. They wanted me to concentrate more on household work. It was just that when it got too much, you know, when I couldn't look after my child because I knew he had all these challenges, that I had to really take a stand and then work on myself. And so, you know, since I have lived a lot by myself, I have always tried to improvise. And you know, that I lost many years of my life. One of the reasons that once I couldn't complete you know, as much of my studies as I wanted to at a younger age, I felt that I had a lot of talent and potential, and I had given up even actually decades of my young age. And so I wanted to do something, wanted to do the best of whatever I am involved in. And so, you know, God has created this journey for me. In my young age, I never thought that I would ever be into bodybuilding. But then that is what has happened.
On that note, ma'am, aap ek baar apni audience ke liye flex kar dijiye. You got that. Ma'am, as we boast of having come a long way since independence, I think gender disparity still exists in our country to the fullest. Right? Male bodybuilders are being given the recognition, but I think female bodybuilders are not being awarded the recognition that they deserve. Do you think you have got what you truly deserved and wanted out of this industry?
You know, bodybuilding for women, when it comes to competitive bodybuilding, yes, there's no doubt about it that women do not get, you know, what they deserve, because people want to see very freaky things. You know, when this, you see a male bodybuilder, then he's all out with muscles, and that is the very perception of bodybuilding. But people don't look at a good figure which has been well built and well developed, you know, they don't associate it with a lot of hard work. Now, you know, I don't want to be very technical, but a woman's body she's an estrogen dominated individual. She cannot have that kind of freaky large muscles. It is absolutely ridiculous and freaky. It is bizarre to say that a woman should be like that. The best of a woman is a glamorous, and you know, so people mix it with the, you know, sexuality and something which they see. The women are not looked upon with that much respect. So whereas if a woman has to actually do it, it takes hell of a lot of you know, strength and stamina and endurance and courage. So I feel that paradigm change in the thought process must be brought when, you know, of course in many aspects of womanhood, but yes, because we are talking about bodybuilding here, then certainly yes, that there is no understanding and awareness about how a woman should be. When I look at a lot of women, you know, in the outside world, outside the bodybuilding world, they all just want to get thin, 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 and so that they can wear a particular dress. Nobody looks at fitness as something that you can do till the end of your life and sustain and live your life to the fullest potential. So a lot depends on the women themselves as to what they want from bodybuilding. they may not get money, they may not get awards. I too feel that I have worked a lot, I have done everything alone at a time when nobody else was doing it. I've traveled all over the world single-handedly, but and you know, there was no support from the Federation, no sponsors, all that. I'm not complaining. I did it because I wanted to do it. But you know what a woman must think is that when considering the current circumstances, that what she can get from bodybuilding, what she can learn, how she can condition her mind to you know, get acclimatized to a lifestyle that will help her to live her life to her fullest potential until the end. So if you expect that from life, then bodybuilding will give you that. But if you think of awards and recognition, as of now, women do not get it at all.
Ma'am, I must say, you are a woman of steel. When life offered you lemons, you knew how to make lemonade out of it. What would you like to say to those aspiring male and female bodybuilders who are still chained to the stigma that is prevalent in our society?
For all male and female bodybuilders, I would say that, you know, this is a subjective sport. And there is no quantitative analysis when it comes to results. I am also an international judge, and when I see so many athletes on stage, it is a very remarkable moment because I have been there at some point of time, and all of them are very well conditioned, all of them have worked hard, all of them have their six packs showing, all of them have done all the sacrifices, lost money, traveled, and you know, sacrifice their social life and so on and so forth. It's only one person who gets an award. So if you attach too much to a competition and you know, end up harming yourself going to a low fat level that can do damage to you, you should not go further in that. Bodybuilders must see whether they have the genetic potential and the backing to see that, you know, they are able to sustain that very, very difficult journey. As Arnold has said, it is the most difficult sport in the world, actually. Mm-hmm. Because you got to be along with it 24 hours. You don't get rest, you don't get a break at all, no matter what. So if you attach yourself emotionally to it, it will really hurt you. You may be damn good. But when I see an international stage, I have seen the people from India have done their best to their genetic potential. How do you know that somebody from Russia or Sweden or Norway, somebody from some country will come, and they might have better gyms, better diet, better amount of backing and better genetic potential? Like if I work hard and say I will work hard and become 6 feet, I cannot do that. I don't have control over that. So I feel that whatever journey you have gone into in any aspect of life, there has to be a parallel sense of detachment. That is the key, parallel sense of detachment, that you do your best, but don't worry about the result. And that holds for everything in life. And that is also the essence of Bhagavad Gita.
To watch more such untold stories, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. आपको वीडियो जैसा भी लगे मुझे नीचे कमेंट सेक्शन में बताएं। अगर अच्छा लगा तो लाइक करें और दोस्तों के साथ शेयर करें।